Good morning everyone. Today we are going to revise chapter number 6 and the name of the chapter is square and square root. Today we'll discuss some main topics from this chapter, starting with the topic number 1. In this we'll check how to find whether the given number is a perfect square or not. So any number will be given to you and we have to check whether that given number is a perfect square or not. So what we have to just remember in our mind, if a number ends with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. Again, whenever a number will end with these unit digits, 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9, then that number will be a perfect square. Okay, one condition with 0 is that 0 should be of even numbers. Even number means 2 zeros, 4 zeros, 6 zeros, like this. If we have only 1 zero at the end, or we can say that 1 zero at the unit digit, then that number will not be a perfect square. Okay, again I am repeating, if a number ends with the digit 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9, only in that case the given number will be a perfect square. And what is the exception with 0? We must have even number of zeros, like 2, 4, 6. If we have these even number of zeros at the end, only then that given number is a perfect square. But if we have 1, 0, 3 zeros or 5 zeros, then that number will not be a perfect square. Example, if we have 121, here the unit digit is 1. 1 is here, it means 121 is a perfect square. Okay, here it is 9. We know that 9 is here, so 9 is a perfect square. Next, 90. See, here we have only 10. It means odd number of zeros. It means this is not a perfect square. If we have 900, how many zeros are here? Here we have 2 zeros. It means it is an even number of zeros. So 900 is a perfect square. One more example, 64, 4 is at the end, it is a perfect square. 640, 10, not a perfect square. 6400, 2 zeros, it means this is a perfect square. So whenever there will be a question that we have to find whether the given number is a perfect square or not, what we have to check? We have to check the unit digit is 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9, and the next thing is that the number of zeros should be even. If the number of zeros is odd, then that number will not be a perfect square. One more example, 123. Here 3 is at the unit place. So this is not a perfect square. Next, we have to check what will be the unit digit of the squares of the given number. Let's say we have the square of 81 and we have to find out what will be the unit digit of its square. This, if we'll square this 81, then which number will come at the unit place? Now just check, at the unit place we have 1, so the square of 1 is 1. So whenever we'll square this 81, then 1 will come at the unit place. Next example, if we have 24 and we have to find which number will come at the unit digit if we square this number. Now just check, 4 is at the unit place and the square of 4 is 16, and here 6 is coming at the unit place. So whenever we'll just square 24, then 6 will come at the unit place, or we can say that 6 will be the unit digit in the square of 24. Next, if we have 240, now just see, here we have 0. So we know that again it will be 0. So 0 will come at the unit digit. One more example, 428. See, 8 is at the unit digit and the square of 8 is 64. Here 4 is coming here. It means whenever we'll just square this 428, then 4 will come as the unit digit.